Hello everyone, welcome back to my Let's Play of Nioh. This is part 5 of my Let's Play, and today we are going to go back to the Isles of Demons to do a clean sweep, hopefully, of 5 different reputation challenges. We'll head into the title list real quick here, so I can show exactly why we're going back to that dreaded mission. I'm going to go for Power of Life and Death, clearing a main mission without killing any other enemy than the boss. Clearing a mission without dying or praying at a shrine. Clearing a mission without having a guardian spirit equipped. And clearing it while wearing no armor at all. Now, this could either go really great or really shit. So to start off with, we're going to go into the starting point here and go to the shrine where we can unequip our guardian spirit. We can't start the mission with it. And then we're going to go into our equipment menu and we are going to unassign all of our armor. Yeah. Looking studly, William. Okay. Without further ado, let's jump balls deep into the Isles of Demons yet again. Best outcome, I pull it off. First go. Worst, well, hilarity ensures, and I die time and time and time and time and time and time again. Nah. We're gonna do it. We're gonna do it, and we're gonna do it well. Let's go. Okay. So to start off, well, whilst I'm gonna be doing this speedy, I'm also gonna grab whatever items and Amrita I can that's laying around on dead bodies. Smash up a few crates and boxes. And I'm going to take you the best way I know for this level to avoid most of the dangerous hassles and enemies. We're gonna go around behind this, like, fish rack, so we don't attract his attention. Give this fellow up there a wide berth. We'll creep over here and grab that Amrita though. Continue running up. There's the fellow around the corner here, he's gonna spot us. But what we're gonna do is we're going to get his attention, lure him back here a little bit. And then when he takes another swing at us, like so, we're going to run for it. And leave him for dead. And we're going to head straight up into the hills here. Yeah, I believe we lost that fellow. And what we're going to do is we're going to avoid that fellow with the torch and come up onto the hilltop here. Grab some of this gear. Stone and some foot soldier armor. A little bit more Amrita. And before he sees us, we're going to sneak up onto this hill and we're going to take it very slowly so this archer over there doesn't notice us. And we're going to sneak around the corner here towards the level's second shrine. Okay, pick up this pace a little. Now there's the asshole up the top here that's going to try and ambush us. We're going to quickly run around the corner and drop down a few ledges. And then we'll be in the courtyard with that building that houses the yokai and the residence key. So, head around here real quick. We'll grab that. Oh, he wants to follow us. We'll run past him real quickly. And I'm just waiting to see if we lost him. Yes, we did. Now what we've got to do is we've got to trigger the yokai and get that key behind him. The best way to do that is to get him to follow us out the front door. Oh, he's got a friend now. Fuck. Minor setback. We're going to burst through the wall here. Got the key. Out we go. Moving at the speed of sound, running down the hill to get away from assholes. Now we're going to run down here as far as we can, and hopefully they'll give up the chase. Yep. So there's the final shrine for the level. We're going to run back up here and grab whatever's on this dead body. And next up, we're going to drop down onto this ledge and go across here and gather up yet a few more items. Now there's a number of ways we can do the next part. We're not going for the yokai, that's for sure. We're going to head up behind this cue ball here. And we're going to move really quick. Up the ladder. Up the ladder. Yep. There we go. And now we just want to gun it. We want to gun it like we've never gunned it before. Drop down here. Try and lose these assholes. We're going to run around here real quick. And head up this ladder. There we go. Drop down. So we're gonna move as quietly as we can so we don't get spotted by the arch there. But if we hear the loud noise, that noise, we know that we've been spotted and he's gonna be firing at us. And what we're gonna do is run across here real quick. And to avoid this yokai, we're gonna drop down this side. Run past the revenant. Not Revenant, Dweller, sorry. Run through here. Run along here real quick to try and lose them. And hopefully, yeah, they've given up the chase. So we'll smash a few boxes there. Which is all good. I'm gonna creep around here. And what we're going to do is, there are three fellows around here. That dude with the spear and those two at the foot of the tower. And we're just going to make a mad dash for it towards the boss. Oh, shit. Dodge, dodge, dodge. Pop an elixir because we don't want to die. Keep running. Okay, now here's the hard part. Surviving him. So again, strategy like last time, skirt around the side, smash any obstacles that can impede our progress. Pots, boxes, what have you. This time I don't have a living weapon to take down a bulk of his energy though. And one hit from those balls will no doubt kill us. Or bring us very close. So we'll run up here, take a quick shot at him. If we're hit, we're dead. At least that's the way I'm treating it at the moment. So I'm gonna play this as safe as possible. Take a ranged jab every now and then. Use our speed to our advantage to keep him at range. until those balls and chains come off his wrists, and we're stuck fighting him in a fist fight, a one-sided fist fight, mind you, where he has the height, he has the strength, and he can pound us into a William pancake in no time at all. Now, we'd rather that not happen, although I'm sure Keg is cheering for the monster right now. Yeah, I'm not stepping any closer to you, mate. So, we busted his horns. That should lower his attack power a little bit. Take that. Oh. And again. Run over here, grab whatever's on the ground. An elixir. That brings us back up to 8. Take a quick shot at him with the matchlock. Run. Another shot. Run. I think we've got like one more shot. There we go. And now it gets interesting. Dodge! Dodge! Okay. Come on, mate. Oh, he's going for the ball again. Dodge! Dodge, dodge, dodge. Oh, here come the balls. Great balls of fire. Oh, come on, dude. You're big, I'm small. Come at me, bro. Oh, here comes the belly flop. And get a few shots in. Now he wants to take his ball and go home. We're going to dodge it. Going to go for another one? No. Oh, that was a little close for comfort. Just keep whittling him down with the weight on the end of the Kusarigama there. Here comes the belly flop. In for a few quick strikes. Not going to be too greedy there. We'll let him go for his ball. Get ready to dodge. Here he comes again. Damn, you're ugly. Oh, he's going for the ball again. We're going to dodge that shit. Because I'd rather not get bowled over like a bowling pin. Because I'm not a bowling pin. I am an Englishman in my undies. Okay, come on, dude. Do something completely stupid. Do we have any arrows? Yes, we do. Oh, there he goes. A few quick hits. Dodge the ball. There he goes again. And dodge. Okay, come on, man. Here he goes, dodge, move to the side, get an arrow ready. I totally fucked that up. Oh, dodge that. Oh, no thank you. I don't think he likes the way I'm playing at the moment. Come on, man. There's the belly flop. In for another few quick strikes. Back off! Fuck! Well, there goes our no hit. Which is another challenge. I wasn't going for it though. So it doesn't matter. It would have been a great bonus. Oh shit! Shit! Heal. Okay. Another ranged attack. Oh, shit. Shit! Ah! Fuck you! Now, what happened there is the controls get rather finicky. rather than throwing my weight, he decided to swing on a high attack. And that usually happens if you're holding back at the time after you dodge. So if you're still holding back, he's going to lurch forward instead and... well, yeah, you saw what happened. Now, there's no real reason to continue from here because... well, hell. We died! So I'm going to use that to quit out of the level. You know, there's no grave to go back to, the Guardian Spirit, we didn't have it equipped. So... there's no point in going all that way to try and collect Amrita that isn't there. If I'm going to do these challenges, I want to do them, you know, in the one sweep. So, oh, that's death to bandits. Trying one more time. The same way. Oh, that sucks. That battle was going so well as well, and then, you know... ass controls. No, it's stupid ass me, really. So, yeah. If you're holding back when you go for a heavy attack, he'll do this. So, that's what I wanted. If you're holding back after a dodge, he'll just sort of... oh, he doesn't want to do it now, does he? Yeah, he'll do that. When you dodge backwards. Right now I'm having difficulty doing it because I'm not locked onto an enemy, but after a dodge, if you're still holding in a direction, he'll wave his Kusaragama rather than hurl it out like that. And ultimately, that's what killed me there. So again, a spot of bad luck, but there's nothing I can do about it, except try again. Though this time we don't have any matchlock ammo, which is a drag. So again, lure this idiot around again, have him swipe at you, and then run for the hills. Run to the hills. Run for your lives. Up here. Sneak past the archer. Sneak through the hills. Run for your life. Run past him, into the hut, wait to see if we've lost them, otherwise we've got to adapt a little bit. Yep, we've lost them. Get the Amrita off this dude, and a small spirit stone. Aggro the yokai. Oh shit! That arsehole's still lurking around. Get the key. Come on, dude. Leave me alone. Go back to the hills. And run down the hill. Grab the Amrita at this grave here. You know, I'm optimistic. We're going to do it this time. The last time was, yeah... yeah, bad luck happened, and yeah, it's to be expected in a game like this. Yeah, sure, there are people that can do the game naked and without getting hit and whatever. I'm not one of those people. Not yet, at least. You know me, it's amateur hour. So we're going to have him swing at us. Oh, fuck you, man. No, I'm not bowing out like this. No, what we're going to do is we're going to lure these armored fellows around the huts and then sneak up the ladder while they're trying to chase me. Run past the archer. Drop down there. And duck around the corner real quick. Take a little bit of a breather. Sneak up this ladder. Sneak across here. This idiot's going to fire his arrow. Now we're going to run at him. That'll give him pause to think for a moment. Long enough for us to sneak by and run for our life. Free to shack here. Past that dweller. And into the distance. Hopefully where we've lost him. I believe so. Okay. Now here comes the fun part. Rather than dodging three enemies, I'm going to get this guy to take a swing at me. Run real... Come on, dodge! Heal up and run for the ship. There we go. Okay. Second time lucky, hopefully. Onryoki just did us a huge favor by destroying some boxes there for us. Or is it on Ryoki? It's the classic Street Fighter Ninja Gaiden conundrum there. Is it pronounced Ryu or Ryu? I'm not too sure, it never really bothered me all that much. I was more a Balrog Vega fan myself. Okay. So we'll continue dodging. We'll try not to make any stupid mistakes this time around. I'll try not to attack him after a dodge as abruptly as I did when I died. I gotta keep on top of my Kai pulses. It's something that I forget constantly. And yeah, it's not good to forget about Kai pulses. He's out of range. Bummer. However, he's low on Kai there. I was hoping we could get his horn. So dodging around. Keep on moving. Getting another attack. Run. Hit him again. Run. Back into this corner. Go again. Kai pulse. Run down there. Oh, just out of range. You lucky yokai, you. Run down here. Throw. Okay. One more strike and these balls and chains should come off. Nope. One more afterwards. Okay, it's got to be the last one now. There we are. Dodge. Oh, shit, what are you doing? Dodge. For some reason, he wanted to roll forward there. We don't want to roll forward. Okay. Don't go for another hit after that. Throw it. Oh, shit. Well, there goes the no-hit bonus. I'm not even going to go in close to him. I'm just going to throw my weight at him. As it does about as much damage as a decent combo anyways. We're just going to get him to come around after us. Throw the weight. And there he goes again. Throw the weight. Dodge. Fuck! No, out of kite! Not good. There's the belly flop. We're gonna heal. He's going for his bowl. Just gonna change it up a little bit. Oh, shit. Run around again. Come on, man. Missed. Dodge. There he goes for the ground pound. And again, he's going to go for a ball. Dodge. Dodge. And here he comes again for a ground pound. Get him with a few strikes there instead. Dodge. There he goes for the ball. Dodge. Now. Going for another ball, yep. And again. Here he comes. No, he's going for the ball. Dodge. Going for it again. Yeah. And dodge. Oh. Oh, come on. Okay, I see we're going to stick with what works, huh? There's the belly flop. Oh, fuck! There's another belly flop, but we're gonna heal. And then we're gonna throw our weight. Dodge that. He's gonna pound. I'm gonna throw the weight. There's the belly flop. Run in. Back off. He's going to go for his ball. We're gonna dodge that shit. And we've got his attention. He's gonna pound the ground. And again. One more time. He wants to play with the ball some more. Okay, we've got his attention now. Here comes the belly flop. In for a combo. Back off real quick. Another belly flop. Can we get him? There we go. Lone challenger, naked fighter. Okay, so what exactly did we get there? Did we get all of them? They popped up so quick that I didn't see them all. Okay. Yep, there we go. Power of life and death. Invincible Traveler, Lone Challenger, and Naked Fighter, all in one fell swoop. It would have been great to also get on Ryoko Crusher, which is that one there, defeated an on Ryoko without taking a single hit, but unfortunately, yeah, it didn't quite come off. Still, we've defeated two on Ryoko, so we're almost there with the on Ryoko Slayer. And after that, we've got on Ryoko Crusader, killing five of them. Of course, the three carry over onto that, so... Anyways, let's finish this mission. Nicely done. Very nicely done. Not very efficient, yeah. I'm not exactly one to go balls deep in and take every opportunity to attack that I can, throwing caution to the wind. But we got it done at the end of the day. That's the main thing. So heading back to the shrine here, we're going to re-equip our guardian spirit, even though we don't get any most of the boosts from our spirit because our spirit stat is low. Let's see, we've got 4,500. We need 8 at least for that. So I think what we'll do is... I'll boost strength to 8 for now, which will increase our maximum equipment rate and what we can wear. So now we've done that, we'll head into... Oh, what? What is this shit? An error has occurred. 15... La-di-da. Not sure what happened there. Looking along. Scout armor. We'll re-equip what we had. Kai, ninjutsu, damage reduction. Plus 4 to Kai. Doesn't have the ninjutsu. Has better... We'll go with that for now. Item drop rate, human drop rate, unlimited omyo. Let's see. Let's equip the brawler's gloves for the moment. Equip our shinobi pants, our rogue armor. Now we'll go back up to the hands here. Yeah. We'll stick with our... No. Regardless of whether we're wearing all shinobi or not, we're still at a agility ranking of B, so we may as well put on our brawler's gloves and put on the brawler armor, because we've still got an agility of B with that. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to head on in to the blacksmith.
いらっしゃい.
Hello. And we're going to refashion the armor. It costs 200 gold, I believe, to refashion armor. Oh, no. Where is it? Pirate protection. Oh, hang on. Do we have to put it in a storehouse first? Probably. So we'll head on in here, head over to our items, pop that in the storehouse, pop the shinobi gloves in the storehouse. Now we head on to the blacksmith. Refashion armor. Select brawler's armor. There we go. So that'll cost 157 gold to refashion. And go again with the brawler's armor gauntlets and change that to the shinobi. Thank you. Take a look real quick. So right now we look like a shinobi still, but we've got different armor. What did I want to do? I wanted to head to the shrine. That's where I wanted to go. Make some offerings. I'm gonna switch out and see what's rare. Just offer everything that I'm not using at the moment. Foot soldier armor, thief armor, everything except the arm charm. Let's see. So we did that. I think we'll try the Deft Bandit submission. Where we're coming in and we've got to kill two or three of these unique yokai for this area at least, which are like burning wheels. They can be annoying, but hopefully we get it done. So let's give this a try. No, it's not the one I'm thinking of. In this, we're heading in to kill the bandit leader. That's what we're doing here. So, we'll get this fellow's attention. Get a backstab. Ooh. Yeah, we'll just go with that. Bugger it. So he's got a friend shooting at us with bow and arrow over there. There we go. Wasted your shot. Got some arrows for our troubles. Run in here and nothing. I think there's a dude waiting around the corner, no? Oh, there's a dude there though, he almost got me too. Throw the weight at him and I don't think we can take the shortcut in this, it won't let us open the door. So really all we're doing is coming up here to kill this guy and get whatever's around the corner there. So grabbing that, run down here. We'll take the shortcut down here rather than go through the gate there and do battle with other enemies. As you can see, we just got the title Roughneck. That's for destroying a bunch of items. And there we go. Kill him. Knock him off balance again. Wail on him. One more time. Not gonna have any of that. Yeah, I was gonna hit myself with the submissions. I was thinking it was a different submission. That's the second one that unlocks for this area. And unlocks after we... Oh! Someone's seen us. Finish him while he's on the ground. Yeah, it's the second submission that unlocks for this area once we finish mission 2. So, getting way of... Oh! And now finish him off. While he's on the ground. Run up the hill. Bloody crows. Let's get this fellow's attention. He's only a weak fellow. You can usually tell if they're weak or not. The weaker bandits tend to have bald heads and a slightly smaller in stature. Fellows like this with helmets, they tend to take a little more of a beating. Pull him down real quick. One more time. Oh, got a samurai skill for proficiency with our Kisaragama. Looking around. Peek around the corner here, see what we've got. We've got a fellow over there with a spear. We're going to pull him across the front of this gate. It's another weak fellow with a bald head, so he shouldn't be too much trouble. Looking around. Yeah, we'll do battle with this heavy dude over here. Drag him over. Oh, wasted too much Kai there trying to get him. Oh, come on, dude, we're not going to have any of that. Don't even try it. It's not funny. I've been killed twice by a spear. Both times were very tragic. So coming through here. We've got bandits patrolling. This guy is wearing no armor, so if we headshot him... Well, that wasn't a direct headshot, unfortunately. But it was enough to weaken him. Okay, here comes a bolt. One of the weaker looking dudes. Oh shit. Yeah, fuck that. Onto the roof we go. I'll attack him while he's jumping down. There we go. Oh shit, I'm locked onto the wrong one. Oh come on, dude. I'm gonna have to heal. There's no way I'm getting ass chunked by a bottom feeder like that. Not again. It's happened too many times recently. Sorry, Keg, you're just shit out of luck. I'm not dying. Not this time. Kill that fellow. Getting a little cocky there. I ran out of Kai again. Smack a few boxes. See if anything falls out. No. Torch. Run up here. Gather this Amrita and some rifle ammo. Running down here. We've got a fellow sitting on the hill. We're going to ruin his day by coming up behind him and so we just got the title Stealthy One, which was awarded due to having I think 100 attacks from behind. Down upon your belly worm. Yeah, there's one more fellow here. We're gonna grapple him from behind. One more time. And finish him off. smash the boxes here. So our target is in the hut here. That's being guarded by another bandit, whom we're going to throw a rock at. As I'd rather not take them on both at once. Oh, dodge, 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 no! Shit. Laugh it up, Keg, I hear ya. You're laughing, and I don't like it. Okay, running down here. To do battle with the Revenant, or not to do battle with the Revenant. Yeah. May as well, he's there. Let's do him. Oh, it's another asshole with a spear. Back off. Lure him in. Finish him off. There we go. Come along here. Oh, there's two bandits in there anyways. So what we're going to do is we're going to get a headshot on this fellow. And that leaves us one-on-one with the bandit leader. Whom we're going to pull towards us and get with a quick combo there. And again. Let him do his little twirls. Do a Kai dodge there. One more time. Grapple him. Finish him off. And that's the submission. Gather what items there are around here, smash a few crates. Check in here real quick and grab the gold. Thank you. No boxes. Okay. Home and hosed. And that is the submission done. Very nice. I apologize for not reading the flavor text at the start of the submission. I was getting a little ahead of myself. But we're greeted by Hanzo again. Marvelous work, just as I expected. The villagers were overjoyed. They certainly met with a string of misfortunes of late. Let us hope this was the last. And we got Samurai locks, I believe, a couple of talismans, an axe, and some dual katanas. Pretty sweet. So, for now, that's the main mission and submission done there. So, we'll leave that alone for now. We'll go to the shrine, though, and level up real quick. Can get in two levels. What do I want? We'll boost that up to 8. So now I should get a buff from my guardian spirit, which is, I think it was the equipment drop rate, either though it was quick attack damage. Oh, it was something up the top. But now we need 9 spirit, and then we'll get a luck boost of plus 40. And at 11 spirit, we get 400 plus life recovery on using living weapon, which is pretty nifty. We'll also go into the skills real quick, as I got a few points building up. I'm not going to touch magic at the moment, but we're going to come into ninjutsu here, and down the bottom here, we've got composure. Press triangle or square when guarding against a human enemy to take their weapon and perform a counterattack, which can be done when barehanded. It only costs 1 point, so I'll take that. But what we really want is the sneak attack, For enemies who do not notice us, we can use triangle to perform a powerful attack from behind. And that'll come in handy. We'll grab the catwalking skulls to skills to open up this last one here. Gives us access to Supper Scroll. And then I'm going to grab this passive buff, which allows us to carry more sacred water. Sacred water can be used to refill our Kai, much like elixirs do our health. And I'll grab... what do I want? Increases barehanded damage. That's a passive. Tiger Running Scrolls. Jutsu. I'll come down here and grab the skill to allow us to carry power pills as well. Now we'll come across to the Kusaragama. I'm going to spend 3 points on this. Basically, we can power up when unsheathing our weapon. It's kind of like a Kaioken boost for a moment. It boosts our attack, but it sort of lowers our defense. But it's handy when starting off. We're going to go for the kick while guarding. So we've got 4 more points to play around with. Changing to another stance on a successful Kai pulse increases the amount of Kai recovered. What do we got here? Mid stance. Low stance only. Follows up a combo with a back step. We'll take that. Mid low stance. Follows up a combo. Do you want to assign it to the... yeah, we'll take that instead of the low stance one there. That's all our samurai skill points used. So now that we've unlocked multiple different skills using the triangle on the end of a combo, we can come in here and change them around in the skill customization. So where was it? Kusarigama. Summer Twilight. We want low stance. So we can either pick that one or that one. We've got two different ones to pick out of. So that one does that. And this. Actually, I think I'll take Retreating Strike. Anyways, this concludes part 5 of my Let's Play of Nioh. Next time, we're going to tackle Mission 2, Deep in the Shadows. This has been Kara Alexia. See you next time.